Hey guys, in today's video we will be looking at a problem of counting subarrays with sum equal to its Zor value. So this is a problem based on sliding window protocol which we saw in the last video. So if you haven't checked out that video, first I will recommend that you will check out that video and then come to this video. So let's try to understand the problem statement first. So we have an example array of size 3 and the elements are 1, 2 and 3. So I have written all the subarrays, possible subarrays of this array. So we have 6 subarrays here. Now let me try to count how many subarrays have sum equal to Zor value. So what I meant by that is 1. So sum of a single element is the element itself and XOR is also that same. So here we'll get 1 and 1, here 2 and 2 and 3 and 3. By this we know that whenever there is a single element inside the array or a subarray, it always shows this property of sum equal to its XOR value. So these all are showing this property. So here we have a count of 3, so we have 3 such subarrays. Now with size 2, I have these 2 subarray. I'll do for 1 and 2, 1 XOR with 2 will be, I'll write 0 1 and 1 0, so it will be 1 1 which is equal to 3. Okay, and sum of 2 and 1 is also equal to 3, so 1 plus 2 is also equal to 3. So these both are similar. That means this is a subarray which is showing us that property. Now for 2 and 3, 2 XOR with 3 and 2 plus 3, so 2 plus 3 is 5 and 2 XOR with 3 will be 1. So 1 and 5 are not equal, so this element doesn't show that property, this subarray. For size 3 we have a single subarray 1, 2 and 3 which is the complete array. I will do XOR of these 3, 1 XOR 2 XOR 3. So we have 1 XOR 2 as 3, we have calculated it previously, and 3 XOR 3 will be equal to 0. And sum will be 6. So 6 and 0 are not equal, so this also doesn't show this property. So we have 4. Answer that we have to return is 4, because there were 4 such subarrays, this one and these 3, which showed this property. Now let's talk about the approach. So what can be the approach to solving this problem? Let's think how we can apply sliding window in this. So let me take the first element. So we will first take this element 1, sorry, and then we will check out that property. For first element, I'll check this property. So for every single element, this will be a valid subarray. So I can check these 3, and then I can check with size 2, which will be this one and this one, and then I can check with size 3. So here we can see we have this overlapping. We can see this overlapping. So in order to reduce this overlapping, we can apply sliding window to this. So how we will do that? Let's see. Okay, so let's talk about the algorithm. So we can start with the first element itself. Let me write it here. 0, 1 and 2. I'll start from here. I'll take 2 pointers or elements. One will point here at the initial point and R will also point here, and for storing the final answer I'll keep another variable answer. I'll initialize it to 0, and one more variable I will keep is X. So X also I will initialize with 0. I'll let you know what is the use of this X once we start exploring this algorithm. So let's start with the 0th element. So I can traverse the array with a for loop. So let's not write the code in this one. Let's see the approach first. So I can start with this element. So I have 1 right now, and L is equal to 0 and R is also equal to 0. So inside what I can check is that, is this element showing this property? So for that I can do while R is less than N, and for this property I'll write ARR. Or let me write A XOR with X. So A of R. a of r, right? A of r XOR with x is equal to a of r plus x, right? So this is for that condition of a valid subarray. And if both of these conditions satisfy, what I can do is I can update my x to, let me write it simply, x equal to x plus a of r. So I'll include this element inside x, and I can increase r plus plus for that. Now once this property gets violated, either this one or this one, we will come out of this while loop, and we will have a value of r. So let me dry run on this one. So I'll go for this. So l is equal to 0 and r is equal to 0 and x is equal to 0, answer equal to 0. So I'll write while that same condition. I'm not rewriting it. So for in that condition, r 0 is less than n is 3, and answer x is 0 right now. So 0 XOR with a of 0, which is 1. So this is 1, is either equal to 0 plus a of 0. So this condition is also satisfied, because this will give us 1 and this will also give us 1. And now r will become 1. So r will become 1, l was 0, and we come on to this element. And x will also be increased, so x will become now 1, because we will add 1 inside that, right? And now l is equal to, so l we will not change for now because this is inside a for loop. We'll see that in code. Now we will check for r equal to 1. So r 1 is less than 3, right? And now another condition, which is now our x is equal to 1. So 1 XOR with 2. 2 is a of r, and a of r is a of 1. A of r and r is equal to 1. So a of 1 inside this is 2, and we will check if this is equal to 1 plus 2, right? So this we saw that it was equal to 3. This one was also equal to 3, so they both are equal. Now we will increase r by 1, so r will become 2, and x will also be changed. So 1 plus 2, it will become 3. Now for r equal to 2, 2 is less than 3, right? And now our x is 3. 3 XOR with 3 is equal to 3 plus 3. So this will give us 0, and this will give us 6. So now the condition is broken. So we will come out of this for loop. Now after coming out of this for loop, what we will check, we have to check that if L is equal to equal to R. L is equal to R means that we couldn't find any element. Okay. Like if there was a single element 0 and this was also equal to 0. So in this case, what I will do is let's say two elements we have, 0 and 1. So if L is equal to 0 and R is equal to 0, that means we didn't find any such subarray. We will increase R by 1. So it will start pointing here next time, because checking this element again would be silly. We won't do that. So if L is equal to R, we will increase R. R plus plus, and before that I'll update my answer variable. So answer will be plus equal to R minus L. Okay, so from the previous example we can come here, R was equal to 2. Okay, R was equal to 2 and L was equal to 0. So R minus L will be 2 minus 0, which will be equal to 2. So this 2 tells us that there were 2 subarrays. That till now we have checked 2 subarrays. How 2 subarrays? Because we had 1, 2 and 3. We know 1 till now. Then 1, 2. This and this one. So we have checked for these 2. So these are the 2 subarrays. Right. So we added that to our answer variable. And now what we have to do here. So for this if, let me erase it. And our answer variable was 2 minus 0, that is equal to 2. In the else part, if there was a increase in r, what I will do, I'll do x minus equal to a of l. Now this is the main part where we are sliding the window. How we are sliding the window, let's see. So 1, 2, and 3, this is what we have. Our l is equal to 0, okay, and our r is equal to 2. So right now we are here, but we have checked for this element that how many subarrays we can have. Now we want to, we have this window, okay, now we want to slide this window. How we can do that? So we can slide it up till this point. Now we have to check the this part of the subarray, this, because this element is already done. So I can slide this window by decreasing this. So x right now is equal to, let me check, x at last was equal to 3. Okay, so I'll do 3 minus 1, which will become 2. So now we have only 2. So we have we are cutting out this element for sliding the window. Now we have window on 2 and 3 only. So let me do again for 2 and 3. So now l will become 1, r was equal to 2, right? And now we have element 1, 2 and 3, but this one is of no use right now because l is equal to 1. So this will be 1 and this will be 2 and this will be 0. Now we will check for r. So r is equal to 2. Let me write another variables as well. So I'll check that while condition again. R which is 2, 2 is less than 3. Yeah, sure. And x which is equal to 2, XOR with 3. And is this equal to, now we'll check for 2 plus 3, which is 5, right? And this is 1. So we know that 1 is not equal to 5. So this condition is broken. We come outside of that for loop and then we will again check if l is equal to r. So that condition is false. No, first we will update answer. So answer plus equal to l minus r, and l was r is no r minus l, sorry, 2 minus 1, which is equal to 1. Answer previously was 2 and then we added 1 inside that, it will become 3, right? And now in the else part we had x minus equal to a of l. So we have 2 and 3 now. We have checked for 2, so we will subtract that right here. So now 3 is the only element left. So l will be equal to 2, r will also be equal to 2 now. Now let's look for this one. So for l equal to 2, r equal to 2, answer is equal to 3. We will check the first condition inside while, which is 2 is less than 3. Yes, and a of 2 XOR with x, x is 0, and either it is equal to a of 2 plus 0. So this will be equal to 3, this will also be equal to 3, both of these are equal, right? So now r will become 3, but 3 is not less than 3, so 3 less than 3, no. We will come outside that for loop. Now we will do answer plus equal to r minus l. So r was equal to what, 3, l was equal to 2, we will get 1. And now, so we are getting 1, and 3 plus 1 is equal to 4. So that is our answer, right? Now let's look at the code. So I have taken the array here, which is 1, 2 and 3. I have calculated its size by using size property. I have initialized all those elements, answer r and x to 0, and here I am traversing the array. So here I am traversing array. Here is that for while loop which we saw while running that example, and this is the same code which we did. So this is updating the answer and we are returning or printing out this answer. So this code is given in the description itself. You can check it out there. I hope this problem was clear to you. And if this video helped you, please subscribe to the channel and hit the like button. Thank you.